The code for this blockwaking game consists of three main elements: the paddle, the ball, and the bricks. The global variables include instances for the paddle and ball, an array for storing bricks, the number of rows and columns for the brick layout, and variables to calculate the brick width and height. The setup function initializes the canvas, creates the paddle and ball, calculates the brick dimensions, and calls createBricks to generate the brick layout. The draw function serves as the game's main loop. It first clears the screen with a black background, then draws and moves the paddle according to the mouse position. The ball is displayed and updated using the update method. The program checks for collisions between the ball and the paddle using checkPaddle, and between the ball and the bricks using checkBricks. Finally, it iterates through the bricks array and renders each brick. The createBricks function positions the bricks in a grid using a nested loop, calculating their coordinates based on row and column indices before adding them to the array. The paddle class defines the paddle's width, height, and initial position. The show method renders the paddle, while move updates its position based on the mouse. The constrain function ensures the paddle does not move outside the screen boundaries. The ball class sets the ball's radius, initial position, and movement speed. The most critical part of the game is the speed inversion mechanism. In the update method, the ball moves according to its speed values. If it hits the left or right wall, the X direction speed is reversed. If it hits the top boundary, the Y direction speed is reversed. However, if the ball reaches the bottom of the screen, no loop stops the game. The checkPaddle method detects if the ball collides with the paddle. If so, the Y direction speed is inverted. This speed reversal is the core gameplay mechanic, allowing the player to continuously hit the ball and keep the game in motion. The checkBricks method determines if the ball hits a brick. If a collision is detected, the brick is removed from the array and the Y direction speed is reversed. This mechanism is crucial because it enables the ball to bounce off bricks instead of passing through them, making the game interactive and dynamic. The brick class assigns the brick's position and dimensions. The show method renders each brick as an orange rectangle. With these components, the blockwaking gameplay is fully functional. However, speed inversion is the most essential mechanic of the game. Without it, the ball would move in a straight line without bouncing, making gameplay impossible. The ability to reverse speed upon collision defines the movement and ensures that the game remains engaging.